Good morning, dear students. I hope everybody is fine and healthy at home. In the last session, we have completed the sixth chapter, that was Annie of Green Gables. Okay? And at the last of the session, I have explained direct and indirect speech. I hope it is clear to you all. Now today, we'll see the exercise of the direct indirect speech that is given on this lesson. Okay, so we will see again what all the rules are given to change the sentences from direct to indirect speech. Okay, in the last session I have told what is a direct speech. Direct speech is a sentence written exactly what is told by a speaker. Okay, that is written in single inverted comma or double inverted comma, like Ram said, I will bring a cake. Okay, now here the sentence is written, Ram said, I will bring a cake. Okay, so here what Ram said, that is exactly as it is written, and here I have used inverted comma. So what exactly is said by a person when it is written the same way using the inverted comma, that is known as direct speech. Okay, when we change the sentence, when we change the sentence in our own word, then it is known as indirect speech. So this sentence, it will be Ram said, I will bring a cake. Here it will be Ram. This I have told said, that is known as reporting verb. Okay. So in the place of reporting verb, we can use other verbs like suggested, commented, ordered, asked. Okay. According to the sentence. Here it is only written Ram said. Okay. Simple statement it is. So here we will use Ram said only. Ram said. And after the reporting verb, we will use the conjunction that. Remember that. We have to use the conjunction that. Okay. Ram said that. And then we will change this reporting speech. This is known as what is written in inverted comma. That is known as reporting speech. Okay. So I will bring a cake. That is reporting speech. Now reporting speech, we will write here without using inverted comma. Okay. So after the conjunction that, we will use this reporting speech, but we will make some necessary changes here. Okay, whatever pronoun is there in the inverted comma, that will be changed according to the context, according to the speaker. Okay, so here who is saying, Ram said, I will bring a cake. Who is I here? I means here, that is Ram. So for Ram, which pronoun we will use here? That is he. Okay, Ram said that he. Now here see the tense. Here it is simple future tense. Okay, whenever in simple future tense will is there, will change to would. If may is there, can, these all may will change to might, can will change to could. Okay, if it is shall, it will change to should. Okay, so here it is will, so it will change to he would. Okay, then same thing, he would bring a cake. Okay, Ram said that he would bring a cake. Okay, so now this sentence, the same sentence what Ram said, I have written in my own words. Okay, so here the meaning is not changing, but only the tense is changing. Okay, Ram said what he said, that he would bring a cake. So now here it is in reporting, that is a indirect speech. Okay, one more sentence we will see. Priya said to Mohan. Okay. Priya said to Mohan, I will help you. Okay. Now see this sentence. Priya said to Mohan, I will help you. Okay. Now here you can see after the reporting verb. Okay, now here set to is used, and then the listener is also mentioned here. To whom she is speaking? She is speaking to Mohan. Okay, so whenever the reporting verb, after the reporting verb, listener is also mentioned. Okay, whenever it is used, said to. Here it was only said. So said will remain said only. But whenever said to is there, what you have to use? You have to change the reporting verb in told. Okay, so here in the place of said to, we will use here told. Okay, so it will be Priya told. Priya told, and then you have to write the listener name. Okay, Priya told Mohan. You will not write here told to, that will be wrong. Okay, you have to use directly Priya told Mohan. Okay, Priya told Mohan, and then the conjunction, that is that. Okay, that, and then you have to remove this comma, inverted comma, and after the reporting, after the conjunction, you have to use this reporting speech. Okay, now see the pronoun here, I. Who is I here? Priya said to Mohan, I will help you. Who is I? I means here, that is Priya. Okay, so Priya, which pronoun you will use here? That will be she. Okay, Priya told Mohan that she, and will be changed to, just like I have told, that will change to would. Okay, that she would help you. Now here another pronoun is there. You means to whom she is saying that she will help? You means to Mohan. So for Mohan you will use another pronoun here. Okay, would help him. This way we will change. Okay, so some common rules we have already seen, that while changing from direct to indirect speech, okay, we will use in the place of reporting verb, we will change some other reporting verbs. Like here we have used told. If it is a suggestion, you can write there suggested. If it is advice, you can write advised. If it is a question, you have to use questioned, interrogated also, inquired of. Okay, if it is order, you can use ordered, requested, commented. Okay, this way reporting verb will change. Okay, and after changing the reporting verb, you have to add a conjunction there, that is that. Okay, after using the conjunction that, then you have to write the reporting speech. Reporting speech means whatever is written in the single inverted or double inverted comma. Okay, and then whatever pronoun is given inside the inverted comma, that you have to change according to the context to whom it refers. Okay, like here I was referring to Ram, but in this sentence I was referring to Priya, he was referring to Mohan, so accordingly we have used here she and him. Okay, these all changes will be there. And then you have to remove inverted commas, okay, when you change from direct to indirect speech. Okay, and then tense also. Tense I have already told. Tense also, that will be changed according to the tense. Okay, if it is present tense, whatever present tense it is, present tense will change to same kind of past tense. Okay, whatever present tense it will be, that will be changed to same kind of past tense. That means if it is simple present tense, okay, if it is simple present tense, that will be changed to simple past tense. Okay, if it is present perfect, that will be changed to past perfect. Okay, if it is present continuous tense, that will be changed to past continuous tense. Okay, if it is present perfect tense, that it, then it will be changed to past perfect tense. Okay, and if it is simple past tense, if it is simple past tense, then it will be changed to past perfect tense. Okay, this way we will change. You will study in detail in grammar also. Okay, so I will show some examples here. Okay, Okay. Now I'll show the tenses, different tense, how to change from direct to indirect speech. Okay. Now I will take a simple present tense. Okay. Priya said I cook food. Okay, now here you can see Priya said I cook food. Okay, I cook food, which tense it is? It is simple present tense. Okay, simple present tense will change to simple past tense. Okay, so it will be Priya said. Okay, here we'll write only said, because said to is not written. Said to Mohan, Priya or Mahesh, nothing is given here. So here it will be Priya said only. Okay, Priya said that. Who is I here? I means Priya. Okay, so Priya said that she, now I have to change this into simple past tense. So it will be she cooked food. She cooked food. Okay, so this way simple present tense will change to simple past tense. Okay. Amit said to Babu. Okay. Amit said to Babu, I am making tea. Okay, Amit said to Babu, I am making tea. Okay, so here the sentence is, here you can see the reporting verb is said to. Okay, whenever said to is there, what you have to change into? That you have to change into told. Okay, so it will be, and here you can see the tense of this reporting speech. What it is? I am making tea. Which tense it is? It is present continuous tense. So present continuous tense will change to past continuous tense. Okay, so it will be Amit told Babu that. Okay, you have to add your convention that Amit told Babu that. Who was making tea? Here I means who? I means Amit. Okay, so it will be that he was, okay, it is I am making tea, present continuous tense, so it will be changed to past continuous tense. He was making tea. Okay, clear? So this way we will change the present continuous to past continuous tense. Okay, now next we will see if the sentence, if the reporting speech is present perfect tense. Rita said to Mohan. See, Rita said to Mohan, inverted comma. Rita said to Mohan, I have baked a cake for you. Rita said to Mohan, I have baked a cake for you. I have baked a cake for you. Which tense it is? That is present perfect tense. Okay. So present perfect tense, that will be changed to past perfect tense. Okay. So it will be Rita. Here again it is said to is used. So in the place of said to, you have to use told. Okay. Rita told Mohan. And after Mohan, you have to add here conjunction that. Who is I here? I means Rita. So for Rita, you will use a pronoun she. Okay, that she. I have baked a cake. It is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense will change to past perfect tense. So here it will be she had. She had baked a cake for whom? Now here it is written for you. You means who? for whom you is used, that is used for Mohan. So we will use another pronoun here. He for him. Full stop. Okay. So this way we will change the sentences if it is present perfect tense. Okay. Now if it is simple past tense, okay, if the sentence is in simple past tense, that will be changed to past perfect tense. Okay. Okay, we'll see now if the reporting speech is simple past tense, like Pari said to Golu. Okay, Pari said to Golu, I ate chocolate. Pari said to Golu, I ate chocolate. Okay. So here you can see the reporting speech. I ate chocolate. Which tense it is? It is simple past tense. Okay. Simple past tense, that will be changed to past perfect tense. Okay. It will change to past perfect tense. So here the reporting verb is said to. So that will be changed to told. Okay. So it will be Pari told Golu. That, who is I here? I means that is Pari. Okay, so for Pari we will use she. Pari told Golu that she, here it is simple past tense, I ate. So that will be changed to past perfect. So it will be she had eaten chocolate. Pari told Golu that she had eaten chocolate. Okay, so this way if it is present simple past tense, that will be changed to past perfect tense. Okay, and if it is past continuous tense will change to past perfect continuous tense. Okay, for example, Monu said, I was reading. Monu said, I was reading. Okay, so in the place of this, Monu said that, it will be past perfect continuous tense. It will be Monu said that he, in the place of I, who is I here? That is Monu. That will be he had been reading. Okay, so this will be for past continuous tense. Okay, past perfect tense it won't change into indirect speech. There won't be any change. Okay, then in future tense, if it is future tense, will change to, I have already told, it will be changed to would. Can is there if the helping verb, that will be changed to could. May will change to might. Okay, and shall is there, that will be changed to should. Okay, so this way we will change the tenses. Okay, now we'll see the exercise what is given in the book. Okay, you have already got the answers for this exercise. You must have written also in the copy, but we'll see how to change these sentences. Okay, first sentence we will see first. Okay, so first sentence is given here, the wrestler said, I have won. Okay, so here first sentence is given, the wrestler said, I have won. I have won, which tense it is? That is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense, that will be changed to past perfect tense. So it will be, the wrestler said. It is said, so it will be said only. If it is said to, then it will be changed to told. Okay. So the wrestler said, now conjunction we will add here, that, who is I here? That is wrestler. So for wrestler you will use here he. Okay. that he had. Okay, present perfect tense, that will be changed to past perfect. So he had one. Okay, so that is the first answer. Second one is, the girl said to the traveler, I will give you a precious jewel. Okay, the girl said to the traveler, I will give you a precious jewel. Okay, so now here see the sentence, the reporting verb is given here, said to. So I have told, if it is said to and then the listener is mentioned there, what you have to use there? You have to use told there. Okay, so here it will be, the girl told the traveler. Don't write told to the traveler, that is wrong. Okay, said, the girl told the traveler, then conjunction you have to add here, that I will give you. I means who is here? I, that means the girl. So here you use she. Okay, will. I have told, if it is will, what you have to use there? You have to use would. So here it will be, she would, same thing, then give you. You is who here? Who is you here? That is the traveler. So here it will be him. She would give him a precious jewel. Okay, this is the answer. Okay, so this way you have to change. I am telling word to word how to change it, though you have written the answer, but see and understand it, how to change the sentences from direct to indirect sentence. Okay, so the girl told the traveler, okay, told is used because here it is said to. Okay, that she would, here it is will, so it will change to would give him, okay, a precious jewel. The next is, the speaker said, I am very happy to be here this evening. The speaker said, I am very happy to be here this evening. Now here you can see some words are written that is showing the place or the time. Okay, so here, like here, this. Okay, so here will change to there and this will change to that evening. So here it will be, the speaker said. Here it is said is written, so here it will be said only. The speaker said. Then conjunction, that I am very happy. Who is I here? The speaker. So it will be that he, I am very happy. I am very happy, which tense it is? It is present continuous tense. So it will be, he was very happy to be there. Here will change to there. To be there. That evening. Okay. To be there that evening. Okay. Now next is fourth one. Okay. Now fourth sentence is, the miller told the king, my daughter can spin gold from straw. Okay. My daughter can spin. That is simple present tense. And here you can see can is there. Okay. So can will be changed to could. Okay. And the other changes you have to do here. It is already written here told. So no change, it will be told only. Okay, so it will be, the miller told the king that my daughter, whose daughter it is? That is miller's daughter. So it will be that his daughter. daughter. Can will be changed to could. Could spin gold from straw. Okay, so that is the fourth answer. Then fifth is Jack said to his mother, I have sold the cow for 5 beans. Okay, Jack said to his mother. Again, here it is said to. So for said to, we will use here told. Okay, so it will be Jack told his mother. I, who is I here? That is Jack. So it will be his mother that, conjunction will add here, that he have means that is simple, that is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense will change to past perfect. So he had sold the cow for 5 beans. Okay, clear? So this way we will change the sentences from direct to indirect speech. Okay, so we have seen how the words will change according to the context. The pronoun you have to change according to the listener and the speaker. Okay, if the listener is used there, then you have to change the pronouns accordingly. And the tense also I have told, that same way you have to change the tenses. Now one more exercise is there, that is just opposite of what we have done just now. That means the sentences are already given in indirect speech and you have to change into direct speech. Okay, so there you have to do just opposite. Okay, you have to see if it is told, then you have to use their said to. Okay, like this. And then the pronoun you have to use for whom it is used. And then you have to use your comma, inverted comma also. Okay. Now one by one we'll see all the examples also. This sentences of this exercise. Okay. So first sentence of the second exercise that is given here. The wolf told Little Red Riding Hood that he could see her better with his big eyes. Okay. So here the reporting verb you can see here that is written here told. Okay. So for told we will use here said to, because I have told before when we are changing from direct to indirect, for said to we are writing told. So here told is given, so we have to do it opposite. So in the place of told we will write here said to. Okay, so it will be the wolf said to whom he said, that is Little Red Riding Hood. Okay, till here, till hood. Okay, then here it is written that. That means from there reporting speech is starting. Okay, so here we will use the comma and then we will start writing in inverted comma. Inverted comma you have to open from here. Okay, what he said, he could see her better with his big eyes. Who is he here means that is the wolf. The wolf is saying. So for he we will use here I. Okay, so it will be I could. Could is there, so I have told if it is can, it will be changed to could. So here it is could given, so it will be changed to can. I can see her better. Her means whom. Whom she is telling. She is telling to Little Red Riding Hood. Okay, so here it will be I can see you, because the wolf is talking to Little Red Riding Hood. When we talk to someone, we use their you. Okay, you are seen. Okay, like this. So here, I can see you better with his big eyes. Whose big eyes? That will be for wolf. So with mine. Okay, so it will be with my big eyes. Full stop, inverted comma, close. Okay, so this way we will change the sentence from indirect to direct speech. In direct speech, you have to use comma and inverted comma. Then only it will be direct speech. Means the exact word, what he said, what the wolf said, that we have to write here. Second one. Hansel told Gretel to drop the bread crumbs on the path. Okay, next sentence is Hansel said that Hansel told Gretel to drop the breadcrumbs on the path. Okay, so here he is saying to Gretel. Okay, so in the place of told, I have already told what we have to use there. We have to use said to. So it will be Hansel said to Gretel. Now here to drop. Okay, so from here the reporting speech is starting. So here we will use comma and inverted comma open. Okay. So here directly we will write here drop. Okay. Drop, here it is a order. That is why here to drop is used. So here it will be drop the bread crumb on the path. Okay. Inverted comma close. Don't forget to put inverted commas. Okay, otherwise it will be wrong. No marks will be given. Okay, so make sure that you put comma after the listener or the reporting verb, and then you have to start the inverted comma also. Okay, and at the end you have to close the inverted comma. Okay. Now next sentence is. Okay, so next sentence is third one. The grasshopper said that he wanted to sing and dance in summer. Okay, so here said is there, so we will use here said only. Okay, so it will be the grasshopper said. After said, you have to use comma and then inverted comma open. Okay, that he wanted. Who wanted? That means the grasshopper. So you will use here I. Okay, said I wanted. Wanted is the tense, is here past tense. I wanted to sing. Okay, simple past tense. So simple past tense will change back to simple present tense. So it will be I want to sing and dance in summer. And inverted comma close. Okay, so it was present tense, so it will be changed to simple past tense. Next is Cinderella told the fairy godmother that she wished to go to the ball. Now here Cinderella told the fairy godmother that she wished to go to the ball. Okay, so here said is told is written, and we will use here said to. Here we can write the sentence in two ways. Okay, so we can write here like this: Cinderella said to. Okay, said to. Then you can write the fairy godmother directly, or you can use fairy godmother in inverted comma also. Okay, so it will be to the fairy godmother godmother, then here it is written that. That means from here the reporting speech is starting. So here it will be comma and inverted comma. She wished. Who wished here? That means Cinderella. So for Cinderella we will use here I. I wished. It is simple past tense. So it will change to present tense. I wish to go to the ball. Okay. Inverted comma. Close. You can write the sentence this way also, or you can write this way. Cinderella said, comma, inverted comma open. Then directly you will write the fairy godmother. Fairy god. Fairy godmother. Then comma here. Okay, fairy godmother, comma, I wish to go to the ball. And inverted comma, close this. There are two ways to write this sentence. Okay, either directly you write the said to the fairy godmother and then comma, I wish to go to the ball, or Cinderella said. Okay, to whom she said? Here she is addressing the fairy godmother, means she is talking to fairy godmother and saying, the fairy godmother, I wish to go to the ball. Okay, this is the way you can write this sentence. Okay, now the last one. Okay, so fifth sentence is, Birbal told Akbar that he knew who the thief was. Okay, so he had told Akbar it is. Okay, so in the place of told, what we will use? We will use here said to. Okay, so it will be Birbal said to. Okay, said to whom he said? To Akbar. Akbar, then comma, because here that is written. So here we use in comma and then inverted comma open. He knew. Who knew? That means Akbar. Sorry, this Birbal. So for Birbal, we will use here I. I knew. I knew means which tense it is? Simple past tense. Okay, so past tense will change to present tense. So it will be I know who the thief was, it is written. So it will be who the thief is. Okay. And then full stop, inverted comma, close. Okay. So this is the exercise we have done today. That is direct to indirect speech and indirect speech to direct speech. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay. So you must have already written these answers in the copy, I know. But I have explained here so that you will understand how to change the sentences. In grammar also, later words, you will study this direct to indirect speech. There you will study in more detail. Okay. So our first semester portion, that is completed. So there are 6 chapters. Okay, first 6 chapter that will be coming in the first semester. 2 poems are given, but you have to learn only one poem for exam. That is the Kayak. Okay, that is lesson number 4. Okay, the Kayak, that is a memorizing poem. You will be getting your syllabus on the school website. Okay, from there you can download it. And your summer assignment, okay, your summer assignment is, you have to write the poem, the Kayak only, what is memorizing that poem, you have to write the poem in neat and clean handwriting and learn also, that is your assignment. You have to write it in either, if you have old, your Milky file, what you are using for summer assignments, if you have, you can use that, or you can use old test copies also. Okay, last year's test copy, there may be 1 or 2, 3 pages must be used. So you can take out those pages and you can use it as your summer assignment work. Okay, so first page you will be writing summer assignment. Okay, there you will write the summer assignment, decorate it as you wish, class, roll number, write a roll number properly. Okay, class roll number, subject. Okay. And then in the new page, okay, Okay, like this is an old test copy I have. So if some pages are used, you can take out those pages and then from new page there you can write summer assignment and then your details, and from new page again you will start writing. From this side you will start writing, write the heading, whatever question is given, that is write and learn the poem The Kayak. Okay, that will be also published in the school website. From there you can download it. So first question you will be writing here with black pen. Don't use color pens. Okay, use black and blue only. You can write the question here, then write the full poem. Okay, and the other side you can draw the picture also, what picture is given in the book, or you can draw any other picture of a boat, a kayak is there and a person is there sitting moving on the sea. Okay, ICC, that you can draw it. Okay, so write the poem, then full poem you have to write, decorate it, but don't decorate on the writing. Okay, where you are writing, don't decorate there. Okay, sideways you can decorate and write neatly. Okay, the second assignment is, that is learn and write the word meanings of lesson 1 and 2. Okay, so lesson 1 and 2, whatever word meaning is given, to write in the copy. Okay, in the copy whatever is given, okay, that you have to write again in the assignment, and you have to learn also these word meanings. Okay, so two questions are there for summer assignment. The first one is write and learn the poem The Kayak. Okay, that is a memorizing poem, anyhow you have to learn it, so that is the assignment, so that you will learn in advance also. Before only I have told to learn this poem, some of you might have learned also, isn't it? That's very good that you have learned the poem. Okay, and the second question is to write and learn the word meanings of lesson 1 and 2. Okay, so you will be writing, and how you will write, before I forgot to tell, whenever you are writing the word meaning, draw a margin in between. Okay, draw a margin in between, then one side word, the other side meaning. Use black and blue pen. Okay, black pen for word and blue pen for meaning. Okay, write neatly and do your work in neat handwriting. Do it slowly but in neat handwriting. Okay, so I hope assignment is clear to everyone. If you are using this file to write it, okay, you can use that Milky file, or if you wish you can make the file by your own also using A4 sheet paper or drawing sheet to draw something on that, that you can do it. Okay, so when you are writing in the ruled paper, write it neatly. Okay, so that was your assignment, and the lessons are already completed. I hope you people have understood all the lessons and must have started writing also, and keep on learning because you have enough time to learn. Okay, so keep on learning question answers, word meaning, exercises, whatever is given. Okay, so have a nice day and good luck. Keep on studying and be at home and stay safe.